So good morning to my dear legendary students. Welcome back to online webinar classes.
So good morning, sir.
Thodi aap jo aaj is you was in college. So welcome back. Today we are going to discussing about we are discussing about sericulture. What is sericulture? Okay, we are going to discussing about what, ma? Sericulture. So I think screen is visible, ma. Screen is visible.
Visible.
Okay. Sericulture means what? So sericulture means rearing of and rearing and production of silk, rearing of silkworms for the production of silk is called what, ma? Sericulture. Okay, so very very important. What does, ma? 2 minutes are there. What am I meaning? 2 minutes. Rearing. Okay, and production of silk. Okay, rearing and production of silk. So from the silkworm. Okay, so that is called what, ma? Very well, that is called sericulture.
Idea.
Yes. One more definition. The definition is, okay, what is definition? What happened, ma? Rearing of silkworms for the production of what happened, ma? So silk. Rearing of silkworm for the production of silk is called sericulture. Is called what, ma? Sericulture. So this is today we are going to discussing about the fantastic topic. Don't miss it. So today I would like to take. So that is sericulture topic, right? Once again, I repeat. What is sericulture? So to describe the sericulture. What is sericulture? To describe the life cycle of Bombax mori. Right. We'll explain one by one in detail. Now let us. What are the contents? Are they in this is the our sericulture topic? Okay. See introduction. Okay. What are the introduction? What are the contents are there we'll discussing? See, one is introduction and history and types of silkworms, life cycle of silkworm and sericulture stage of production and production and share and that means sericulture opportunities and that means sericulture in India and these are the important for the future for the employment of the students, employment of the for people. Okay, what are the important thing? So introduction. See, what is sericulture? Very well. Okay, what is sericulture? See, sericulture means the word sericulture is derived from the Greek word. Sericulture is derived from the Greek word, that is sericos. Okay, sericos means seri, that means seri means silk, cos means culture. Okay, so what, ma? The sericulture is derived from Greek word. Sericulture is derived from the Greek word, that is sericos. Okay, sericos, which contains two words are there, na? One is seri, nothing but silk, and cos means culture, right? So that is very important. Two words are there. Clear? Now the rearing. What is the definition? What is the definition of sericulture? Very well, the rearing of silkworm. Just now I told you, rearing of silkworm, production of silk is called sericulture. rearing of silkworm for the production of silk is called sericulture. Already one more definition is already told. Rearing and production of silk from the silkworm. Okay, that is called what? Sericulture. In fact, the sericulture referred to large scale rearing of silk, producing organism in order to obtain a silk. Okay, so that is one of the important point. Silk is secreted by, already told you in the introduction class, the silk actually, it is a, that means the silk should be secreted from the insects. Okay, that is important about the silk thread, the silk which is secreted from the salivary gland. That means silk gland is there. The salivary gland is modified as a silk gland in insects. That's why the silk is secreted from silk gland of the silkworm, and it is a fibrous protein insect's origin. Okay, now that is very, very important. And very important thing, the silk fiber consists of two types of proteins are there. How many types, ma? Two types of proteins are there, especially for the silk, which is made up of fibroin protein, that is 80%, and sericin protein 20%. What is important of fibroin? Fibroin, which is what, ma? The thread should be made up of fibroin protein. The thread should be shining. Okay, nowadays we are wearing something, silk sarees, silk cloths, silk napkins, okay, silk whatever it may be, garments, whatever it may be, right? So the silk thread, which is made up of what, ma? Fibroin protein, and silk, the silk should be shining. So that is by sericin protein. Okay, now so in the silk thread, the 80% of fibroin is there, 20% of sericin is there. And in worldwide, we should observe, in worldwide, okay, the China is the first place. The China is the first rank in the production of silk in worldwide. In India, the second largest production of the silk after China, we compare it. So in India, the first place is Karnataka. Okay, so huge, largest consumer of the silk in the world of India. So whatever it may be, sarees, whatever the cloths, whatever it may be, ornaments, whatever it may be, spiritual. So we should be using huge, the largest consumer of the silk in the world, especially for India. Remember one thing. Okay, now see, right? What is, just now I have told you, what is in detail sericulture, already told. Sericulture or silk farming is a rearing of silkworms for the production of silk. Okay, that is one of the definition, fantastic definition for sericulture. Sericulture is both, it is a both art of science, raising silk form for the silk production. It is a science, one of the art. Okay, so the silkworm, you know very well, that is what happened, ma? It is a one of the an art and science, raising silkworm for the silk production, right? So that is one of the important thing. See, among the species of silkworm, so many species are there. That is, the Bombax mori is the most widely used for the production of silk. Okay, so worldwide, whatever it may be, China, whatever it may be, Japan, whatever it may be, in India, okay, the fantastic, the peculiar species we should be using, that is called Bombax mori. Bombax mori. The silk is known as, silk is the known as queen of textile. You know very well, the luxurious sarees, luxurious shirts, luxurious ornaments, okay, should prepare from the silk. Okay, now. Very important. That's why the silk is known as queen of textile. Okay, that is called biosteel. What, ma? That is called what, ma? Biosteel, because of its strength is there. Because of its strength is there. That is one of the important point about the. Okay. See, what is mariculture? See, very sometimes we'll asking very important question for short question. What is mariculture? You know very well. So actually, the silkworm for in the larval stage must be eat something, the food, something must be feed. The feed is, that is mulberry leaves. Mulberry leaves. Okay. So that is what is mariculture? But rearing and production of mulberry leaves for the production of silk, for the feeding of silkworms. That is called mariculture. Okay. Mariculture is the science of mulberry cultivation to rear silkworm for the silk production. What, ma? Mariculture means what, ma? The science of mulberry cultivation. to rear silk worm, but the silk production, okay, that is very important. I think may edible visible, Usha, Rajita, Adiba.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your cooperation.
Yes, sir. Visible, edible.
Okay, okay. Next month, bank bags, Bombex feed specially on white mulberry leaves. But also, okay, don't nice, ma. Don't nice. Don't disturb, please. Okay. So I respect your time. Ma, please. Okay. Thank you. See what happened, ma. So these mulberry silkworms not only eat. So few of the silkworms to eat only mulberry. For the cultivation of these mulberry trees, okay, for the rearing of production of silkworms for the silk production, that is called moriculture. But few of the silkworms to eat another plants also, another plant leaves also. So that is eat the osage leaves are there, oranges leaves are there, and lettuce. Very important for your PG entrance level, for CSR net level. It is very important, ma. So only Bombax mori, which is to eat only mulberry leaves, but it is also eat osage, oranges, and lettuce. For the some of the silkworms to eat this type of leaves, it is another type. That is mulberry. If the silkworm should be eat only mulberry leaves for the production of silk, okay, that silk is called mulberry silk. Okay, if few of the silkworms to eat non-mulberry leaves, that means osage, oranges, and lettuce. Okay, that type of what happened, ma? See, that type of silk is called what, ma? Non-mulberry silk. Okay, now let us coming to point. See, history of a silk. Okay, so history of silk, what, ma? So a Chinese, actually, you know, it's a fantastic story, ma. It's a fantastic story how the silk, which is what happened, ma? We are the silk industry is to be started, sericulture is to be started, in which place, in what is a fantastic story is there. See, it is started in China, ma. First the silk industry started from the China. So what the fantastic story here, right? See, Chinese tale of the discovery of the silkworms by ancient empress Li Zhu. Who scientist, ma? Li Zhu is empress. Li Zhu is a queen of the China, empress, and the wife of the emperor. So both are drinking a tea. Okay, that means below of the mulberry tree. What happened? See here. See, she was drinking a tea under a tree when a silk cocoon fell into her teacup, or the hot teacup, right? So immediately, what happened, ma? See, the loose end, the strong, long strand of the silk, where the insect to be, the cocoon should be fell down into the teacup. Immediately, what happened? One thread should be formed. So that thread, as a silk picked out that thread and started wrap the silk thread around the finger. Okay, now so the thread should be formed around of the things, like continuously the thread should be reeling around of the finger. She slowly felt warm sensation. Okay, so warm sensation, that means the hot tea, the cocoon should be dyed and the thread should be formed. So she has a fantastic idea. Why don't we start this by using of these cocoons? We should be prepared one thread. So that's why, that is a fantastic story. When the silk ran out, she saw a small larva in the cup of tea. She realized that this is a caterpillar. So of the larva, the force of the silk. Okay, that caterpillar to be converted into a cocoon, the cocoon to be releasing in that cocoon stage, that insect to be, what happened, ma? Released, then being threads on. C thought, what happened, ma? This is to the people and to become a widespread. Why don't we should start the sericulture threads by using of these cocoons, by using of these insects? So she got the fantastic idea and implemented in what happened, ma? In China, in BC 2000, nearly 2800 to 3000. 2800 to 3000. It is a nearly 200 years. It's a very secret culture. The secret industry in China. Later, it should be spread throughout the world. So we are taking the idea from China to India, imported, and Japan also imported that idea. Okay, so that is one of the important thing. Okay, now this is the fantastic story for the you must be read in the examination. Right. Next. So here, see. Here, so what happened? See, you are in the diagram. The Chinese Empress, that means the Queen of China, she drinking a tea under a tree, the mulberry tree. The silkworm cocoons falls in the tea, cup of tea. The silk strand, okay, that means unravels and larva exposed. Okay, this is the diagram to shows the fantastic story about the sericulture. Clear? Now, see. Now the start of the China is the origin of sericulture. Okay, the China is the origin of sericulture. See, Chinese lady named His Ling Shi. What, ma? See, His Ling Shi invented mystery of what happened, ma? The silkworm cocoons accidentally. Okay, who is the name? That means she was a name also. It is a tough name. Ling Shi, simply called C Ling Shi. C H silent. C Ling Shi invented the mystery of silkworm cocoons accidentally. Right. So it said the silk is discovered before. What happened? See what happens, ma? It said that silk is discovered before the 3000 BC. All I told you. Nearly 2850 BC. Okay. Art of silk production was a secret up to 200 BC. Just now I told you, for the about 2800 to 3000 BC. Right. So very important thing. 3000 year it was discovered, but 3000 to 2800, nearly 200 years completed. But this sericulture, it was a secret mystery in China only. The latter it spread throughout the world. Trading of silk was through the Silk Road at the time. Okay, now so no one nearly completely the 200 years in China. Okay, nearly completed throughout the China, it completely sericulture industry started. Like one road, one industry. For example, you should take Mao Gunar, one town, one of the industry, and bus stand, one of the industry, Padmavati Colony, Jachalla, Chardar, that means Timmapur, like Hyderabad, like throughout the world. So like that is one of the chain-like structure. Okay, one of the road-like structure to be industry started. That's why the China trading was through the Silk Road at the time. So many industries are started for the production of silk by using of silk worms, right? So by about 300 AD, sericulture has spread to India from Korea. Okay, so after death, BC, nothing but before Christ, after death of Christ, that is AD. So by about 300 AD, sericulture has spread India from Korea. Okay, 300 AD, nothing but that is Vedic period. Okay. 300 AD, nothing but that is Vedic period. Remember one thing. See, Vedic period and that means Mammad Pravakta. That means Mammad Pravakta period, like that. Very important. Okay. In 1857, world sericulture industry suffered from one of the dangerous disease attack. Okay, in 1857, what, ma? The sericulture industry, one of the dangerous disease attacked. The sericulture industry suffered from a huge problem about the disease that is called febrine disease. What happened, ma? Febrine disease which is caused by protozoan parasite. Okay, this is almost destroyed the European sericulture industry. Completely European sericulture industry, it will be destroyed in the the parents of this protozoan disease that is called febrile disease. Okay. See, that means Sogdian silk 18th century. This is the silk, ma, silk design. This Sogdian silk 8th century. 8th century, remembering one thing. Now, see, the Orient discovered the silkworm in the Himalaya region. Orient discovered the silkworm in the sub-Himalayan region, you know very well. Okay, the silk from Kashmir to Bengal was exported from European market during the 14th, 15th century. In India, Kashmir to Bengal, it was exposed to European market during the, because of, in that century, 14th, 15th century, that means India is not independent. It is under, that means European, that means French, under the French, 1857. Anglo-Indians, right? Okay. Tipu Sultan of Mysore laid foundation of Mysore. The Karnataka produces 70% of country raw silk. That's why, you know very well, the pure silk should be, which is a pure silk, but Mysore silk. Mysore means it's a Bangalore. Mysore means what? It's a Karnataka. Nearly, throughout India, nearly 70% of the, what happened? 70% of the silk should be produced from the Karnataka state. That's why in India, the first rank of for the silk production, that is Karnataka state. Clear? Okay. Now, in 1771, Chinese silkworm was introduced in India to improve the quality of cocoons. Improve the quality of cocoon in 1771. Okay. In 1775, Italian methods of rearing worms was introduced by the East India Company. Okay, that is completely this point you must be right in sericulture in India. How to start off sericulture in India? Okay, so 1942, Silk Conference at Delhi. What happened? Silk Conferences at Delhi. So that is 1942 was it. Before the independence, right? The silks expansion scheme to meet the requirement of the parachute of the clothes. Okay, so this expansion scheme for the preparation of the parachute. Requirement the parachute for the preparation of the clothes. Okay, this is a sericulture in India introduction. Now, so what are the silkworms we should be using here? Okay, what are the silkworms we should be using here? You know very well. See, there are five major types of silk commercial. There are the five major type of silk commercial importance. Okay, obtained from the different types of silkworms. Which is turn feed on number of food plants except to mulberry. Already told you now, if the other varieties of silk are generally termed as a non-mulberry silk. Before already told you, mulberry silk and non-mulberry silk. Those are the silkworms, you know very well, those are the silkworms. Okay, those are the silkworms to be eating only mulberry leaves to produce silk that is called mulberry silk. Okay, remaining all silkworms to eat like osage, like orange, like lettuce. Okay, that type of silk is called, what happened ma? That is non-mulberry silks. What ma? Non-mulberry silks. I hope all of you understood these definitions. Mulberry and non-mulberry silks. Okay. Come on, tell me Radhika, what is the difference between non-mulberry and mulberry silks?
Sir, mulberry silk means they interact with eat only mulberry leaves. Non mulberry means which will eat osage, oranges, and lettuce.
Okay.
Is known as non mulberry silks.
Fantastic. Okay. Thank you, Radhika. Thank you very much. Okay. Come on, tell me, Krishna. Come on, tell me one question I asked you. What is mariculture? What is moriculture?
Sir, moriculture means silkworm at the larva stage, cultivation of mulberry trees for the rearing and production of silk by the silkworm is called moriculture.
Wow. Fantastic. Thank you very much. Okay. Now, so what are the, now we are going to, should not wait for the, we are waiting, but what are the silkworms are there? What are the silkworms are they? Now, what are the silkworms, ma? One is mulberry silkworm. Second one is tussar silkworm. Third one is oak tussar silkworm. Fourth one is eerie silkworm. Fifth one is muga silkworm. How many types, ma? Come on, tell me. How many types? Okay. So that is, one is mulberry silkworm. Second one is tussar silkworm. And oak tussar silkworm. And eerie silkworm. And muga silkworm. Remembering one thing. Here, mulberry silkworm only, this is the produces mulberry silk. Remaining tussar, oak, eerie, and muga. Okay. These are, what happened, ma? So completely these second, third, fourth, fifth. Second, third, fourth, fifth. These are the silkworms which are only non-mulberry. Produces non-mulberry silk. Okay. Next. So here, remembering one thing. Okay. Serial number. What are the silkworms? How do, what type of mainly plants are to be eating, plant leaves are to be eating. So that is, you know, very well. Okay. See, type mulberry silk. Okay. See, the mulberry silk. So you know very well, there is a white, the mulberry silk color, that is a white, white and cream color. Okay. And Bombax mori, the family is called Bombycidae. That is how they eat mulberry plant. There is Morus species, and especially for these mulberry silk at Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka. Andhra Pradesh at the Karnataka. And next, what ma? Tropical tussar silk. The tussar silk scientific name, Antheria melita. What ma? The tussar silk, the silkworm. The silk is looking like which color? Copperish in color. Copperish in color. The scientific name, Antheria melita. Antheria melita. So that is family, that is what ma? Saturninidae. Which family? Saturninidae. Remembering what? Saturninidae. And next, what happened, ma? Next, what is these tussar silkworm to eat? That means Arjun leaves. That is Arjun, that means Terminalia arjuna. What ma? Terminalia arjuna is there, and Assam plant, Assam leaves and Sol leaves. Okay, these are the leaves which are the tussar silkworm, Antheria melita silkworm, to eat this type of leaves. And these tussar silk industry, where it is located? See, Jharkhand, Orissa, Chhattisgarh, West Bengal, Andhra Pradesh also. Andhra Pradesh also, right? So this is very important thing. Now, so third one, that means what happened, ma? Oak tussar silk. Oak tussar, that is a temperate tussar. That means it is a not permanent, temperate tussar. So it is a scientific name, Antheria poili. What, ma? Antheria poili. This is it is also the family Saturninidae. And the leaves are called what, ma? Curcus. Curcus, which is the leaves, that is, which is these oak tussar silk which should be produced as in India, that is sub-Himalayan belt. What, ma? Sub-Himalayan belt which should be producing that type of silk. Clear? Now, eerie silk. Eerie silk look like which color? It is a white color. This is what, ma? White color. So that scientific name, Samia cynthia. What, ma? Samia cynthia. It is also the family Saturninidae. Saturninidae. So this eerie silkworm to eat castor leaves. What, ma? Castor leaf, that is the Ricinus communis. Ricinus communis. Castor leaves, nothing but it is look like amudam plants. Telugu, in Telugu, what, ma? In Telugu, in Hindi, you can call it amudamu. Hindi, you can call it, ma? Amudamu. Amudam leaves. The castor leaf, the scientific name, Ricinus communis. Communis. Right. Where it is a industry to production of this eerie silk? Northeastern states, Bihar, West Bengal, and Odisha. Northeastern state, Bihar, and West Bengal. That is a one of the important. And now fourth silk, okay, that is Muga silk. but na muga silk, this muga silk, and some in Telangana, in Andhra Pradesh we can call it munga, munga also n silent, so munga silk, that is muga silk also there, that is golden yellow color. It is look like which color ma? Golden yellow color. That is very very important thing. So the scientific name Antheria asama, what ma? Antheria asama, that is Saturninidae. It is called what ma? Saturninidae. So the leaves, okay, that is som leaves, som som leaves. The scientific name Persia bambusina, Persia bambusina, that is salu. You can call it the plant also called salu plant. Salu leaves also we should be eating. That silkworm should be eating for the production of muga silk. Mainly this type of muga silk industry, muga silk industry which is located at Assam, right? So this is a okay. See what happened, ma? We should be discussing about mulberry silkworm. So this is a mulberry silkworm we discussing. So the bulk of the commercial silk, mulberry silk nothing but what, ma? The bulk of the commercial silk produced in the world, bulk of the commercial silk produced in the world comes from this variety of an silk generally referred as a mulberry silk. Huge, you know, very well, okay, in worldwide to produces only mulberry silk. That's why so huge amount of the milk we should, huge amount of the silk we should be producers by the Bombax Mori, okay, that is mulberry, by using of mulberry leaves. This mulberry silk comes from the silkworm, that is Bombax Mori. Bombax Mori, L means Linnaeus, L means what, my capital means Linnaeus, which is solely feeds on the law in the solely on the leaves of the mulberry plants, okay, that is only one of the mulberry silk, okay. And India, in India you know very well, see in India the major, okay, what happens, Sabha, come and tell me, Sabha.
Hello sir, L means what?
L means Linnaeus, Linnaeus, Linnaeus. Okay, according to my nomenclature, L means Linnaeus. Clear? Okay. Clear, na?
Clear, sir.
Okay, done. Thank you. Thank you very much, Sabha. Thank you very much for your response. And now let us in India, the major mulberry silk producing states are where? One is Karnataka. Second one is Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh, but including Telangana also. Including Telangana also, remember one. Okay, like Pochampalli Pattu is there, Pochampalli Pattu is there, Jamadani Pattu is there, Narampet, Gadwal Pattu is there. So many industries are there for the production of silk, right? One is Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, including Telangana also there, and West Bengal, and Tamil Nadu, and Jammu and Kashmir, which together account for 92% of the country's total mulberry raw silk produced. Okay, and non mulberry like Odisha, like Himachal Pradesh, like okay, northern belt, Assam, northern belt states are to be produces non mulberry silk, as you were already told, right? So that is one of the important. So now the time is completed 40 minutes. Okay, you should take short 20 minutes break. Okay, welcome back to after 20 minutes short break. Thank you very much. This is Krishna, HOD of Zoology. Will continue next class. Okay, na? Thank you very much, ma. Thank you.